Good morning. This is TCR, TroyCommunityRadio.com. I'm Clint Myers on 107.1 WTJN for David DeNoyer on TCTV. Time now for the Main Street Report. And with me this morning is John Wilson. Good morning.
Good morning, Clint.
Another beautiful weekend for us here in Troy.
Oh, a long holiday weekend.
Long holiday weekend. Things off to a good start with the farmer's market this morning.
Yes, I think so. If you're in your car, get on down there. We've got a lot of things going on at the farmer's market this week.
You said added produce. They've got stuff coming out of the fields now.
Stuff's coming out of the fields. Stuff's ripe. So we rotated a few more produce vendors in there this week, Clint.
And you can bring your appetite, too. I hear tell that the Tin Roof Restaurant will be there with their food truck.
Oh, the Tin Roof's there every Saturday. They have all kinds of good stuff. They start in the morning with biscuits and gravy, and it goes on from there.
That sounds good. Now, Farmer's Market started at 9 and goes on until 1 o'clock this afternoon.
1 o'clock, yes. Get there early. Get the best produce. We have all kinds of stuff there. Everything you need for 4th of July. There's pies, cheese. There's even macaroons there, Clint.
Ooh. They've got, now, folks can pick up their burlap bags.
Yes.
For the farmer's market. Reusable.
Absolutely. Bring them every weekend. Fill them up every weekend. They're right there at the information table that Troy Main Street sets up.
Sounds like there'd be a lot of good things you could pick up for your 4th of July picnic, too.
Oh, yeah, there's plenty there. Plenty of vegetables, like I say, plenty of sweets, pies, cheeses. You name it, it's there, as well as many handcrafted arts and different things that you can pick up for gifts for yourself or others.
And a little entertainment as well, Megan Osmond.
Megan's going to be there. Megan's a fantastic entertainer, delightful young lady. She's going to be very successful.
All right. And speaking of 4th of July, we've got the parade Monday, 9 a.m.
Yeah, you got the Veterans Museum putting on the 4th of July parade this year. Hope everybody comes out and supports that as well.
Wear your red, white, and blue and bring your flag and line the streets.
Absolutely.
Now, you were just talking, of course, with the warm temperatures. The last thing we're really thinking about here is Christmas, but we are at that halfway point almost in the year, and the downtown merchants are putting together a Christmas in July.
Yeah, they're putting together a Christmas in July event, Clint. Sorry about that. What we're going to do is put together some in-store specials, and if you visit enough of the participating merchants, there's going to be a basket available that everybody's going to kick in for a prize.
I bet this is going to be a big basket. I know back at Christmas time they did the Win the Window, so, and tons of gifts in there for that. And I would imagine that it's going to be the same thing with the basket.
Well, the preliminary count, Clint, looks at least 20 participants. And if all 20 kick something into that basket, it could be a very viable gift.
All right. And that runs the 12th through the 25th of July.
That is correct.
All right. Well, we'll look forward to some more information on that as we get a little bit closer.
Well, maybe next week we'll bring one of the organizers in and share with us maybe a little bit more information.
Excellent. John, you have anything else that you want to add? You've got some other events that are coming up, too, here in downtown.
It's right around the corner on Tuesday, July 12th is the part of the summer movie series, The Polar Express. It's going to be shown this time. The next two movies, The Polar Express included, are going to be shown in the library parking lot around behind the library.
The big inflatable screen, just like when they did it down on Prouty.
Big inflatable screen, just like down on Prouty. It was cool to have the Star Wars on Prouty, but for a few reasons, we moved it down to the library. I thought that'd be a little bit better venue for everybody.
Well, that way you don't have to worry about traffic out in the streets or with the amount of kids that were there for the movie having any traffic. And plus the noise. That'll give you a little bit more seclusion back behind the library.
Absolutely. It's going to be a real nice event. You know, we also have the little park back there, too. It's going to be very secure and very safe. And should it happen to rain, we'll move the event right on inside the library.
All right. I know Daniel Dye and the Miller Road Band is coming up July 5th for the Lucky Lemonade Concert. And that will be over at the Hainer Cultural Center.
That's at the Hainer Cultural Center, right next door to the library, so you can probably get two shows in one night. And, of course, come down early, get downtown, visit some of the restaurants and the shops downtown before you head that way.
All right. Anything else, John?
I think that's enough for this week.
that's a lot of activity, a lot of things happening here in downtown Troy. Invite everyone to enjoy their Saturday. Make sure you swing past the farmer's market. John, thanks for stopping in and talking to us this morning.
Hey, thank you. Everybody have a nice long weekend.
This has been the Main Street Report on a 4th of July weekend, 107.1 WTJN. I'm Clint Myers, and for David DeNoyer on TCTV.